Hello everybody. So technically I already started this vlog. I started it on Monday, but I filmed Monday and Tuesday on my phone because of convenience. But when I've gone to edit the footage, the sound quality is just not good. Yeah, okay, I could upload it and it'll be fine. It'll only be those few clips, but editing it is just, I don't want to do it. It's just really, I'm not enjoying doing it. We're back here because I don't know why we weren't in the first place, but anyway, it was just so painful having to edit it, and it was just not nice editing it because it just felt wrong. It just felt like I didn't want to put that up because it was just horrible to listen to, because just the quality was really, really bad. I've decided to kind of restart the vlog, which is annoying because I got some good content yesterday. I even vlogged me watching a booktuber, and now that's gone and I feel really bad. It is Wednesday now, my dudes. This vlog may now be shorter now that I'm starting later into the week. Really, all I did yesterday, I'm not going to go into depth, is uni. Uni was all I did the past couple of days. Obviously, I talked about the books I'm going to read and I'm going to quickly go over those. I'm continuing reading The Opposite of Always by Justin A. Reynolds. Want to get that finished this week because I haven't not read much of it. I have, but not as quickly as I want to. Continue reading City of Fallen Angels by Cassandra Clare, which I will hopefully will try and finish this week, but that may be hindered by the fact that I'm now listening to Wuthering Heights on audiobook because I need to read that for my university module. I don't want to read the physical book because I just, even the audiobook I'm finding really hard to engage with and retain anything. So if this book I don't finish listening to or don't finish reading or don't get a full experience, know what the hell's going on, I'm not too pressed because I'm not thinking of doing it for one of my essays. Wuthering Heights may hinder if I can finish City of Fallen Angels this week. Yesterday I talked about one of the films that I saw, I just had to see for one of my modules, and honestly I don't want to talk about that film again. It's called The Dreamers. Go and look it up yourself if you want to know what that is about. And honestly, if you're not used to very, 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 very disturbing sexual content, don't watch it. That's all I'm gonna say. And the booktuber that I was watching, and I'm gonna put her face up here because she deserves her face to be up here, seeing as, you know, I put her face on my video yesterday, or the film clip I filmed yesterday, is Meg's with books. I think that's her thing, because obviously before it was right in front of me, but it's Megan. I'm gonna put Megan's face here. I love her, she's amazing. Her content is chef kiss, and she only has just over 200 subscribers, so please go subscribe to her. She's so good. Go and subscribe to her. So here we are, it is Wednesday. I have just done some work, and I did some really productive work, and I felt so good for me. You know when you just do something like schoolwork, whatever, and before you're like, I don't know if I'm actually going to be that good, I don't know if it's going to be, you know, good content, or I'm actually going to understand what I'm doing, and then you just bash it out and it's like chef kiss. That was what I just did then, and I'm so proud of myself. Really thought these vlogs would get better if I started vlogging on my phone, but the sound quality is utter crap. Utter crap. That's what I'm just saying, it's utter crap. If people who do vlog on their phone, can you give me tips? Because I don't know if it's just my phone that is the reason why it sounds bad, or is it maybe iMovie that makes it sound bad? But I vlog on my phone is over there and I can't be bothered to get it. My phone is an iPhone 6S. I've had it for a couple of years now, and I just wanna know whether it is my phone or if it is iMovie and I just have to stick it out and then it gets better once I upload it. I'm also having a crisis about when I'm gonna be uploading next, or when I'm gonna be able to film and upload due to all my uni work, because now that I'm a few weeks in, I've got to start thinking about deadlines and essays, and I'm not going to worry about it too much, and I am just going to kind of go with the attitude of upload when I can. It is still just stressing me out because I feel like I just don't feel like I'm ever going to be able to upload. Whenever I have the time to film, I will. Leaving this here, I will catch you guys later. I will catch you guys later. Hello everybody. So I'm here to open some book mail. I know what it is. You probably will be able to know what it is if you've watched last week's reading vlog. I am not seeing Joker. I haven't seen Joker. And that's what I'm saying. Don't want to talk about it. I already went into town and said I went to Costa, but I'm just going to open this really quickly, get this over and done with. Oh, that's cute. It's a girl reading a book, like a kind of cyclone tornado come out of it. And the book is Shadow and Bone by Leigh Bardugo. So last week I went on a crazy let's buy all three of the Grishaverse or Grisha trilogy books because I want to read them because of the TV show. And so here is Shadow and Bone. Shadow and Bone came last, which was a bit annoying because I was like, I've got Siege and Storm and Rune and Rising, but don't have Shadow and Bone. But now I do. And once again, can we just appreciate those spines? These books have bonus material inside. So this bonus material is a lost letter from Mao, and I've heard a lot about Mao, many like controversial stuff about Mao. The Tailor, which is I don't know how to pronounce the name, is it Genya or Genya? Their story. I'm really excited to read this. I'm gonna do a read along with some people for this kind of universe, so I'm excited to read this. We're gonna do it in December, start this one in December, so I'm excited to read that. I'm just gonna go and grab my other two so we can have them all together and looking pretty. Here we have them. They look very, very pretty. Look at those spines all together. It's rare for me to have a series all together and not have having had read them all.
There we are.
Don't they look pretty? They look so, so pretty all together, looking divine. So I'm really excited to get into this series at some point. That is it. For now, I'm just gonna relax for a bit just because I'm a little bit today. I read about 50 pages of my book while I was in Costa. I kind of wanna read more because I'm really in a reading mood at the moment, but I also feel like I should do some work, maybe upload tomorrow's video. Like, it's all exported and stuff. I just need to sort out the thumbnail and the caption and upload it. So I'm tempted to do that. And to be fair, if I upload it, then I can read while I'm waiting for it to upload, because I don't usually like to do anything with my laptop while it's uploading. Anyway, I'm gonna leave it here and I will talk to you guys later. Hello, everybody. Excuse me while I'm like half cut off. I've literally put you on the biggest stack of DVDs ever and you're still not high enough. I am in the bathroom at the moment doing my makeup because I'm going out for some friends' birthday drinks and I need to get ready. Even though it's like 4 p.m. I'm going to a friend's before for dinner. So I wanted to update. I didn't film yesterday and we already know that this vlog started later. I didn't want to like miss 2 days in a row and I've already started later. I knew that now would be a good time to film. I'm really sorry if you can't actually see me. The way you can, I can't angle the camera anymore because otherwise it'll be kind of precariously balancing at all because it's up against the window, so I can't actually move it anymore. I wanted to film because then otherwise this vlog will be dead. What updates have I got for you? So yesterday I didn't really do much. I just went to the gym, did some work, had a good productive day yesterday actually. Baked some stuff with my friend, my housemate. That was really it. I just had a very productive chill day. Today I had uni at 11. I had a seminar at 11 to 1. Before I left for university this morning, I started my way into finishing Opposite of Always and I literally had like less than 20 pages left before I had to leave for uni, so I was like, I'm obviously gonna take my book with me as I usually do. And I don't really read on buses anymore because I get bad car sickness, and usually when I'm in Brighton, when I'm back at home, the buses in Brighton aren't as bad, like I can easily read on them, but the ones where I go to university in Canterbury are just for some reason make me feel sick, so I just can't read on them. But I did push myself to read on it today. I kind of knew that I'd be alright because it wasn't like I had to read much, and if I just pushed on, and I was really into the book anyway, so that kind of distracted me. So I ended up finishing Opposite of Always on the bus. So I've been meaning to finish that book for a while, and so I finally have it read, and I gave it a 4.25 out of 5 stars. I really, really did enjoy that book. It was just so pure, so wholesome. I loved all the characters, all the main characters, and I kind of consider all the main characters to be Jack, Kate, Gillian and Franny. This book is about our main character Jack, who meets this girl called Kate at a party. They kind of, you know, fall for each other and they start dating. Like, a few months down the line, Kate dies and then suddenly Jack wakes up. He kind of has this like weird moment and he kind of wakes up back at the party where they met, and he realizes that he's kind of gone back in time, and after a while realizes that he's been given another chance to, in a sense, save Kate, and to kind of, it's kind of like the universe telling him that you and Kate are meant to be, so we're giving you another chance to save her, because Kate, they mentioned she has this thing called sickle cell, which is it's a very common disease. I don't know if you call it a disease, but a very common illness within black people. This book is, all the main characters in this book are not white. We're not strictly told what ethnicity they are, but Kate constantly refers to herself, like, sometimes she'll be like, I'm not a very good dancer for a black girl. We know by the cover that Kate and Jack are people of colour, even though it's not said, but I implied Jack's best friend, Gillian. She is also black because it's mentioned that her dad comes from Cote d'Ivory, which is a West African country, and it is own voices because Justin A. Reynolds is a person of colour. It's not said what ethnicity Franny is, but he calls his grandmother Abuela, which I assumed and implied that he is Latino. So if you're looking for a book with really great POC rep, hit this book up. But anyway, as I was saying, so sickle cell is a very common, or is more found in people of colour. So Jack is given the chance to kind of relive these few months over and over until, you know, he can save her. So we kind of see him deal with the fact that he has time travelled and dealing with, you know, having to work out how he can save Kate. He realises along the way that his actions aren't just going to affect Kate, they're going to affect him and his family and his friends. That was one bit I really loved about the book, is that because he's making all these decisions, he has to,
After all, he learns that he might have to sacrifice a few things if he wants to save Kate. So we see him make some decisions that, as a reader, we think, is that the best? Is that the best move? It kind of shows Jack as a flawed character, because sometimes he does mess up. Because there is one moment where he properly does mess up when he kind of comes back. It is a really good book, and I really, really enjoyed it. And I definitely want to be reading more from Justin A. Reynolds in the future, because I think he's a great writer. It was a really easy, quick read, and I really enjoyed it. I think it's been made into a film, because I think Justin A. Reynolds' pinned tweet is him saying, like, oh, it's been put in for a film, which I think is awesome, because I would love to see that as a film. I am about 45 minutes away from finishing City of Fallen Angels. Hopefully, I might try and finish that either today or tomorrow, like, while I'm traveling. I'm staying over at my friend's tonight, so, you know, I'll have time to read or listen to some on my way there and on my way back tomorrow. I don't think I told you this, but on Wednesday? I think it was Wednesday. I ended up DNFing Wuthering Heights because I really just, I couldn't get into it because I was, in a sense, for, if I had longer to read it, then I think it would be better, but I was almost like forcing myself to get it done by Sunday. I just knew it wasn't going to happen. I just knew I wouldn't be able to retain any of it, and I wasn't retaining any of it, and I just decided that because I'm not planning on writing any of my essays on Wuthering Heights, that I don't really mind if I don't finish it, because I'm planning on doing my first essay on The Haunting of Hill House, which is a book I actually really enjoyed reading. Other than that, I don't really have any other updates. Other than that, don't think I have much to say. I think I might wrap this up now so I don't have to keep talking and doing my makeup. I will see you guys maybe tomorrow. And this is once again gonna be a shortish vlog, but I will see you guys later.
Hello everybody, it is now Saturday. It's about 5:25. I have just got back, or a couple of hours ago, I got back from my friends because I ended up staying at hers for quite a bit after last night. So we went and had drinks with one of our friends from our course. We played some pool and I won the game from our team and just saying. Then we did a spontaneous impromptu kind of trip to the club. Even though the night wasn't, you know, my standard night, it was, the night they had was more like grime and R&B kind of music, which is definitely not my music. Still had a really good time. Come back, I had a shower, because whenever I drink alcohol and then go to the club, my hair just feels disgusting. I've changed my bed clothes because I needed to do it this weekend. We just need to like brighten yourself up. Always to feel like changing your bed clothes, it's just such a good, it's just the perfect thing to do because it gives a new outlook on your room. I had my Harry Potter ones on, which were darker, whereas these ones are just like blue and white kind of patterny ones, which kind of just brighten the room up a little bit, makes me feel a bit more homely because I've had these ones for quite a while. I need to submit something for a deadline that I've got on Monday, but I don't think this vlog's gonna be that exciting because obviously I've started it late and I just haven't really been vlogging at all that much over this few days just because I haven't been in the mood. I'm talking really quietly just because I'm in a really tired mood. I don't know if you can tell, like, I'm really tired. Book wise I did end up finishing City of Fallen Angels yesterday. I was listening to it on my way to my friends and I literally finished it like 5 seconds before I knocked on her door, which was good. I gave that a 4.25 out of 5 stars. I think the reason why I haven't given it a 4.5, which I give a lot of Mortal Instruments or Shadowhunter books, is just because this book, not much really happens. This is obviously the first book in like the second half of the Mortal Instruments series, because she originally was going to make it a trilogy, but then she kind of expanded it into a 6-book series, and this is the first one of like this kind of second half of it. As I said, not much happens, and this book mainly focuses on just developing the characters and getting the characters ready for what's going to happen in the next couple of books. Even though it's nice and I still enjoy it because I love these characters and I love this world, it is just a bit, not boring, but I kind of get to the point where like, oh, I would like to see a bit more action, but I still enjoyed it. It's Shadowhunters, I'm going to enjoy it either way. At the moment, I literally only have one book on the go and it's non-fiction, so we should all be surprised because I rarely ever read non-fiction. And I'm reading This Is Going to Hurt, Secret Diaries of a Junior Doctor by Adam Kay. My mum read it and this is a really popular book at the moment, and my mum read it and I really wanted to read it. It is basically like a diary of all of kind of the things that happen with the Junior Doctor. Apparently it's really hilarious. I'm hoping it's going to be disgusting in points because it is all to do like medically. So it's 97-hour weeks, life and death situations, a constant tsunami of bodily fluids, and the hospital parking meter earns more than you. Scribbled in secret after endless days, sleepless nights and missed weekends, Adam Kay's diaries provide a no holds barred account of his time on the NHS frontline. Hilarious, horrifying and heartbreaking. This is everything you wanted to know and more than a few things you didn't about life on and off the hospital ward. I love stuff like Casualty and Holby City, so I was really excited to read this. I'm gonna end this here because I'm really sleepy and I kind of just want to get on with doing stuff so I don't end up just giving up on today and sleeping or something like that. So I will leave this here. I wouldn't be surprised if I only end up wrapping the vlog up tomorrow. I will see you guys tomorrow. everybody. I'm here to do my wrap up for this week. It's been a bit of a mess this week of this vlog because the majority of it is just me talking. We all know how this week has gone. It's been a bit of a mess. I hope you enjoyed the clip that I just put before of me of a time lapse because I was reading This Is Going to Hurt by Adam Kay, and because it is a real life kind of non-fiction diary book about a doctor, some of the stuff he talks about, and he doesn't hold back, some of the stuff he talks about are just so shocking, even if it's the stuff with the patients. And there was a moment where he kind of said how much he earns an hour, and it was £6.60 an hour. And honestly, I know he's a junior doctor, which I think that was when he got promoted to being a senior housing officer, which sounds really weird when you say senior housing officer. That doesn't sound like anything to do with being a doctor. He said he got promoted to that job and then he was earning about £6.60 an hour, which sounds, I know they probably work more and they do more hours, like doctors do more hours than people who earn that amount of money working in like Primark or something like that. It just baffles me. I'm just gonna wrap the vlog up now using my trusty bullet journal to obviously help me work out how much I've read this week and what I've read this week, because obviously it's not the end of Sunday yet and I still would want to read more of this. From now on, I'm just gonna do last Sunday to this Saturday count up of my page count. That was English, I think. So this week I have read 550 pages. That's not the best. That's actually quite weak. I'm still kind of proud of it in a sense. I have had a busy week, and obviously getting into uni, back into uni, I haven't had much time to read, especially physically. And I have been reading less books. I really, obviously last week I had about 3-4 books on the go, was really this week I've only had 2 to 3. The books I have read this week are The Opposite of Always by Justin A. Reynolds. I finished that and I gave that a 4.25 out of 5 stars. I don't need to go into depth about that, you guys already heard it. I also was reading and finished City of Fallen Angels by Cassandra Clare, and I gave that a 4.25 out of 5 stars as well, but I already talked about that. I started But DNF'd Wuthering Heights. I couldn't hack it, kids. Classics aren't for me unless I have to, or there's something like really motivating me to read a specific classic. It's just probably not gonna happen, and I apologize if anybody doesn't like that. I only read 10 pages of this yesterday, and that was literally all I read at all yesterday. But today I've already read like 31 pages of this, so I'm nearly like a quarter of the way through, and I definitely want to read more of this today because it's just so engaging, really easy to read, and just it's hilarious and so shocking, and just it's just so good, and I'm really glad I picked it up. Some of the stuff are disgusting and you're just like, why are humans like this? There was one moment where he was talking about the times he's had to, and I'm gonna go TMI here, where he's had to extract stuff, objects from rectums. He gave an example of one where a young Italian man who attended hospital with the majority of a toilet brush inside of him bristles first. But the worst, when he said, when he's talking about the one that he was doing like that the day that he wrote this diary entry, but today's the first time I actually believe the patient's story. It's a credible and painful sounding incident with a sofa and a remote control that at the very least had me furrowing my brow and thinking, well, I suppose it could happen. Upon removal of the remote control in theatre, however, we notice it has a condom on it, so maybe it wasn't a complete accident. And that, oh my god, honestly, humans need help. So this is the sort of thing this book contains, just saying. So trigger warning for intense hospital stuff, but it is medical, it happens. So not the most successful reading week, but I still finished a couple of books, which I'm very happy about. I'm really sorry this vlog might be a bit crap, but I know there are some people I know on BookTube who always say that they like boring vlogs, so this one's for you. But I'm gonna wrap it up here. I hope you guys enjoyed it despite it being boring. I have been debating whether I continue doing weekly reading vlogs, because with being at uni they are boring. I am seriously debating whether I continue just doing my weekly reading vlogs, because I like doing this whole at the end of it wrapping up how many pages I have read at the end of the week. But also at the same time, I feel like I do put too much pressure on myself to get up a decent vlog and to film a lot, even though this week has maybe said to me maybe weekly vlogging isn't the best because you don't put much in your vlogs and not much happens. It also tells me that even though I haven't done much and I haven't vlogged much, this vlog is still a decent amount. Like, I've edited up until obviously all the stuff that I filmed today, and it's near 15 minutes, which to be fair is already a decent length of a reading vlog. I'm gonna think about it over tonight. If next week you see a reading vlog from me, a weekly reading vlog from me, obviously that's me deciding that I am gonna continue. I'm more leaning now towards still continuing because I do enjoy them and I like having this structure of having a weekly reading vlog be put up every week. So thank you everybody for watching. I hope you enjoyed. If you're new here, don't forget to subscribe. Hopefully I will keep making weekly reading vlogs, and I try to put up obviously other weekly videos with wrap ups and stuff like that. If I don't put up one week, it is just because I've hectic busy schedule with uni and I just haven't had the time to film and all that sort of stuff. But if you like the sound of that, please subscribe. Obviously like this video, comment down below, whatever you want, telling me that you liked this vlog if you did, or I should stop because this is a mess. All my links are in the description below. Go follow me on Twitter, which I'm probably the most active on in terms of actually like posting. And I will see you all in my next video.